Morning students, class 4. We were reading and discussing about Himalayan states, state of the Himalayas and the Karakoram region. So you know which are the states come under the Karakoram region or the Himalayan states, which are the Himalayan state. This is the new map of India, latest map of India. You can see the changes which has taken place in the political map of India. Okay, which are the Himalayan states? Can you say here? See, Ladakh, Jammu Kashmir, then Himachal Pradesh, then comes Uttarakhand, then Sikkim, then Darjeeling districts of West Bengal, and parts of Arunachal Pradesh are come under this region. These states are come under Himalayan region or the Karakoram regions. So in the previous class we have discussed about Jammu Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh, is it not? Did you not start to draw the map, political map of India, and mark the Himalayan state and the Karakoram range, the states which come under Karakoram range? Did you not start? I told you in the previous class to mark the Himalayan and Karakoram states in the political map of India. Okay, today we are going to read about Uttarakhand. This state come under Himalayan and Karakoram range. So the capital and location of Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand has Dehradun as its capital. Okay, which is the capital of Uttarakhand? Dehradun. This state located in the north of Uttar Pradesh with Himachal Pradesh in its east. This is the location of the state of Uttarakhand. This state located in the north of Uttar Pradesh with Himachal Pradesh in the west. In the north of Uttarakhand comes Uttar Pradesh, and in the west comes Himachal Pradesh. This state is a newly added state in the political map of India, is it not? By dividing Uttar Pradesh. Okay, what is the climate and occupation of the people of the state of Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand? Climate and location of Uttarakhand. This state has pleasant summers, cold winters, and average rainfall. It is the climate of the state of Uttarakhand. How is the summer season there? Summer is pleasant. So what about the cold season? Cold winters. Cold is winter there. So you know, when cold is winter, we need to change our dresses from woolen to, no, from cotton to woolen clothes, is it not? So there the people of Uttarakhand experience cold in winter season. What about the rainfall there? It is moderate. They get average rainfall only. What is the main occupation of the people of Uttarakhand? People are mainly engaged in farming. Farming is the main occupation of the people of Uttarakhand. They grow mainly the crops of rice, wheat, groundnut, pulses, oil seed and soya beans. These are the major crops the people of Uttarakhand cultivate. Which are they? They grow mainly the crops of rice, wheat, groundnut, pulses, oil seed and soya beans. Okay, this is about the climate and occupation of the people of Uttarakhand. Then comes languages and festivals of the state of Uttarakhand. So first, language. People of the state speak Hindi, Pahari, Garhwali and Bhotia. These are the main languages of the people of Uttarakhand. So there is a question as people of which state speak Bhotia language? So the answer is Uttarakhand. Which are the main languages of the people of Uttarakhand? Can you say? They speak Hindi, Pahari, Garhwali and Bhotia. These are the main languages of the people of Uttarakhand. They celebrate festivals, Holi, Deepavali, Dasara and Guru Parva. These are the major festivals of the people of Uttarakhand. Which are they? Can you say? Which are the festivals people of Uttarakhand celebrate? The people of Uttarakhand celebrate the festival of Holi, Deepavali, Dasara and Guru Parva. Okay, this is about languages and festivals of Uttarakhand. Then comes place to visit. Okay, place worthwhile to visit in Uttarakhand are Mussoorie, Dehradun, Haridwar, Rishikesh, Nainital. Then Almora, Pauri. These are the worth visiting places of this state. Okay, if you get opportunity, visit Uttarakhand, these places in Uttarakhand. Okay, Mussoorie, Dehradun, Haridwar, Rishikesh, Nainital, for Almora, Pauri. These places are worthwhile to visit in Uttarakhand. Then comes special features. Special features of Uttarakhand. Special features of the state include Kumbh Mela at Haridwar, IMA at Dehradun. Dehradun is also called the city of school. These are the special features, characteristics, importance of the state of Uttarakhand. Okay, Dehradun is also called the city of school. Okay, then come to Sikkim, another Himalayan state. Come under Karakoram region, Sikkim. The capital and location of Sikkim. Okay, Sikkim's capital is Gangtok. This is the answer for the capital of Sikkim, Gangtok. This is a northeastern state. Has Tibet in its north and West Bengal in its south. See the location of Sikkim. Northeast. See, Sikkim has Tibet in its north and West Bengal in its southern side. Okay, then climate and occupation. How is the climate of the state of Sikkim? This state has temperate climate or moderate climate, average climate. Not much hot or not much coldness is there. They have a moderate climate. How is the night? Night are cold here. Night is cold here. There is regular snowfall accompanied by rains. Another feature of the climate is there is a regular continuous rainfall along with the rains. Okay, along with the rain. With the rain, there will be snowfall also. That is the special feature of the climate of Sikkim. Along with the rain, there will be regular snowfall also. Okay, people are engaged in terrace farming of rice. The people of Sikkim, because of the geographical condition, they practice terrace farming of rice. Other crops are maize, millet, wheat, barley, oranges, tea and cardamom are the other crops cultivated in Sikkim. Okay, the people of Sikkim practice terrace farming. In this picture, you can see people of Himachal Pradesh with their traditional dress, as well as Sikkimese girl with their traditional dress. Okay. People of Bengal, people of Himachal Pradesh, and Sikkimese girl in their traditional dress. And in the picture here, you can see Shiva temple in Kedarinath. It is an important pilgrim place in Uttarakhand. Kedarnath Shiva temple. It is the Kedarnath Shiva temple in Uttarakhand. This right picture is a picture for terrace farming, because it is a hilly area, not a plain area as we have in Uttar Pradesh. So the people of Sikkim and Darjeeling, etc., those Himalayan states, people who stay in Himalayan state practice terrace farming. Picture for terrace farming. Okay, then languages and festivals of Sikkim. People speak Nepali, Sikkimese, Lepcha, Gurgung, and English. These are the major languages the people of Sikkim speak. Okay, mainly they speak Nepali. Then comes Sikkimese. Then Lipcha. Then Gurgung and English. They also speak English language. Okay, then their main festival, major festivals. Their main festivals are Diwali, Dasara, Makar Sankranti, Bhimsen Puja, and Buddhist New Year. Okay, what are the languages people of Sikkim speak? Which are the major festivals of the people of Sikkim that we have seen here? Okay, which are the major main festivals of the people of Sikkim? Diwali, Dasara, Makar Sankranti, Bhimsen Puja, and Buddhist New Year. Okay, then places to visit and special features of Sikkim. State of Sikkim. Places to visit and special features. Special features matlab special significance, importance. Okay, what are the special importance of the state of Sikkim? Rundak Monastery, Haridwar Lake, Bhaktang Waterfall, Buddha Park, and Jawaharlal Nehru Botanical Garden. It is located at Gangtok, the capital of Sikkim, are worth seeing places. These are the tourist attractive places of the state of Sikkim. Which are they? Okay, places to visit: Rumtak Monastery, Haridwar Lake, Bhaktang Waterfall, Buddha Park, and Jawaharlal Nehru Botanical Garden, which is located at Gangtok. Okay, noodle based dishes such as tumka, chowmein, momos, buffalo meat are specialities of Sikkim. Okay, the diet of people of Sikkim. Mainly they eat noodle based dishes such as tumka, chowmein, momos, then buffalo meat. These are the specialities of Sikkim. Okay, then comes Purvanchal range. Okay, Karakoram range is over. So which are the states come under Karakoram range? Or which are the Himalayan state? Can you say? Students, can you say which are the Himalayan state which come under Karakoram range? Jammu Kashmir we have seen. Himachal Pradesh, then Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Darjeeling in West Bengal, and part of Arunachal Pradesh. These are Himalayan states come under Karakoram range. Okay, then now we will learn about Purvanchal hill ranges. Purvanchal hill ranges. In the north east are the Purvanchal ranges. Okay, Purvanchal hill ranges comes in the north east of India. Northeast. Okay, also known as the northeastern hills. These Purvanchal hill ranges are also known in the name of northeastern hills. These hills are not very high. This is the special feature of Purvanchal hill ranges. What is that? These hills are not very high. They are covered with thick forest. Okay, the hills of Purvanchal ranges are covered with thick forest. It is a forest. Okay. Okay, states of the Purvanchal regions. The Purvanchal hill ranges include the northeastern state, namely the eastern part of Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura and Meghalaya. These are the states which come under Purvanchal region. Okay, these states are known as Purvanchal states of the Purvanchal region. Which are the states? Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura and Meghalaya. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 states are come under Purvanchal region. They are known as the state of the Purvanchal region. Okay. The first state is Arunachal Pradesh. Can you locate Arunachal Pradesh in the political map of India? So, this is the political map of India. Okay. Where comes the state of Arunachal Pradesh? Can you locate? This is the state of Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. In the extreme east, the capital is Itanagar. Okay, this state Arunachal Pradesh located here in the eastern side of India, in the extreme eastern part of India lies the state of Arunachal Pradesh. The capital is Itanagar. Itanagar is the capital of Arunachal Pradesh. It is located in the eastern side of India. Okay. This is the political location of the state of Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, students. In the political map of India, you have to mark the states of the Purvanchal region. Okay. So we have seen first Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, state of Arunachal Pradesh. Thank you. Here comes the state of Arunachal Pradesh. You have to mark the Purvanchal states in the political map of India. Okay. This is Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. Then comes Nagaland. Here comes Nagaland. So then comes Manipur. Okay, like that you have to mark all the states which come under Purvanchal region here. Okay, all those six states. That is one of your homework. Arunachal Pradesh. Also you have to read about Arunachal Pradesh and come tomorrow. These are your two homework. Which are they? In the political map of India, you have to mark the state of Arunachal, states of the Purvanchal region. And you, in second, you have to read about the state of Arunachal Pradesh. So, in the political map of India, you have to mark about the Purvanchal states. Okay. Second, you have to read about Arunachal Pradesh and come tomorrow. Okay. So you can drop your homework in my WhatsApp number. Okay, I will check and give you back. So rest of the portion we will cover in the coming classes. If you have doubt, that also you can ask to me. Thank you.